So here, let us do it in a different manner. So here, problem number 22. So n is given directly here in capital N, that is 100. And small n is equal to 5. Because the number of heads up, the maximum value there is 5. That's why small n will be 5. And P. How to find out P is 5 coins were tossed 100 times from the following outcomes. Calculate expected frequencies. So P will be the pro. For example, if a coin is tossed up, what is the probability of getting head? It will be 1 by 2. One head will be there, two faces will be there. So that is 1 by 2 is equal to 0.5. Q is equal to 1 minus 0.5 is equal to 0.5. Okay, so on the basis of this, let us do it. So here, as the information has been given directly, we'll take like this. But in previous problem, nothing has been given there. Once you see there in problem number 21, only x and f values were given. So here the information has been given in the form of paragraphs, so that we need to understand and we have to do the problem. Okay, that you keep in mind. So here, let us do the fitting binomial distribution. So first, I think the formula is n into P of r is equal to n into n cr into P raised to the power of r into Q raised to the power of n minus r. Okay. So first one, P of r is equal to 0. Let us do it. N into P of r is equal to 0 is equal to n value is 100 into small n value is 5, here r value is equal to 0 into 0.5 raised to the power of 0 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5 minus 0, how much will get? 5 is equal to 100 into, already told you, when you are having r value is equal to 0, n may be any value, the answer will be 1 into 0.5 raised to the power of 0, you will get 1 into, okay, I'll tell this technique here. So 5C0, you will get 1 into, as the bases are same, we can add the powers, that is 0.5 raised to the power of 5, that is 0 plus 5, you will get 5. Okay, so hundred into 1 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5, how much you will get?
0.031 25.
Okay, right. 0.03125. So 100 into 1 into 0.03125, you will get 3.125 will be the answer. This is n into p of r is equal to 0. Next one, n into p of r is equal to 1. Into 0.5 raised to the power of 1 into 0.5 raised to the power of 4. So if r value is equal to 1, I told you nc1 answer will be n, that is 5c1 will be 5 into 0.5 raised to the power of 1 plus 4. When the bases are same, I told we can add the powers. 1 plus 4, how much will get? 5. So this answer will always be the same, that is 0.03125. So that is the technique in this problem. 100 into 5 into 0.03125 is equal to
15.625.
Okay. Next. N into P of R equal to 2 is equal to 100 into 5C2 into 0.5 raised to the power of 2 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5 minus 2, how much will get? 3 is equal to 100 into 5C2 answer. How much will get 5C2? Let us find out here. 5C2 is equal to 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial equal to, so 5 minus 2, how much will get? 3 factorial. 3 factorial is the highest value. So highest value I'll write like this, and smallest value I'll expand. 2 into 1. 2 factorial expanded. And here the numerator will expand up to 3 factorial. 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. So 3 factorial, 3 factorial will be cancelled. 2 into 2. So 5 into 2, how much will get? 10. So 5C2 is 10 into 0.5 raised to the power 2 plus 3, how much will get? 5 equal to 100 into 10 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5 is 0.03125. So what is the answer you will get? 100 into 10 into 0.03?
31.25.
31.25. So I'll wait for 1 minute. You please copy the problem. Okay. Next, E of R is equal to 3. N into E of R is equal to 3 is equal to 100 into 5C3 into 0.5 raised to the power of 3 into 0.5 raised to the power of 2 is equal to 100 into 5C3 answer also you will get 10 only. So, but let me do it for your purpose. 5C3 is equal to 5 factorial divided by 5 minus 3 factorial into 2 factorial. Sorry, 3 factorial. So here in denominator 5 minus 3 will get 2 factorial. So it is the smallest value that I will expand into 1 into 3 factorial is a bigger number, but I won't expand it. Now I will expand this 5 factorial in the numerator up to 3 factorial. So 5 into 4 into 3 factorial. 3 factorial, 3 factorial will be cancelled. 2 2's are 4. So you will get 5 into 2, 10. So 10 into 0.5 raised to the power of 3 plus 2, you will get 5. Is equal to 100 into 10 into 0.03125 will be equal to
31.25.
31.25. Next, N into E of R equal to is equal to hundred into pi c four into 0.5 raised to the power of 4 into 0.5 raised to the power of 1 is equal to 100 into, so 5C4 I told you when there is only one value difference between n value and r value, you will get the answer n value. So that is 5 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5 is equal to 100 into 5 into 0.03125 is equal to
15.625.
Next, last one, n into e of r equal to 5 is equal to 5C5 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5 into 0.5 raised to the power of 0 is equal to 100 into, when n value and r values are same, the answer you will get 1 into 0.5 raised to the power of 5. So when powers are same and I added, when the bases are same, when I added the powers, I got 5. Is equal to 100 into 1 into 0.03125 is equal to
3.125.
So you please copy this, we will arrange in one particular order in the next board. Thank you. Next. So let us arrange all these things. Hence, fitted binomial distribution. And 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now find, write the answers. Whatever answers we got here. P of n into P of r is equal to 0, you got 3.125. Again, 31.25, 15.625, 3.125. So what did you note this here? See here, the values have been increased up to 31.25. Again, the same values are decreased up to 3.125. So here, the values are reversed. Means 3.125, again you are having as the last values. 15.625 is there, again last but value here. So in between 31.25, 31.25. So this is possible when p value and q value are same. Okay. So this you keep in mind. When p value and q value are same, these values will be like this. Okay. So keep this in mind. Okay, friends. Today let us complete our class. Tomorrow we'll do problem number 23. We'll meet in the tomorrow's class.